Next problem is, two electric bulbs marked 25 watt at 220 volts and 100 watt at 220 volts are connected in series to a 440 volt supply. Which of the bulb will fuse? Okay. Now, the two bulbs B1 and B2, both of them they are rated at 220 volts and the power is given by V square by R. So the resistance of 25 watt bulb will be more than the resistance of 100 watt bulb because resistance is inversely proportional to the power consumption if rated power is given. Okay, in both the cases 220 volt is common. So we can say resistance of 25 watt bulb is more as compared to 100 watt bulb. Now when they are connected in series and the total potential difference applied is 440 volts, that means it is twice of 220 volt. Now since the resistance of this is more, therefore the voltage drop across this will be more than across this. Now if this is the case, that means the voltage across 25 volt is definitely more than 220 volts and voltage drop across 100 watt will be less than 220. So this bulb will fuse, 25 watt bulb will fuse. Okay. Now let us look at the next problem. This problem is also a very simple problem. Resistance of a given wire is obtained by measuring the current flowing through it and the voltage difference applied across it. If the percentage errors in the measurement of the current and the voltage difference are 3% each, then the error in the value of resistance of the wire is. Resistance is given by potential difference divided by current I. Okay? Let us say you have this resistance R and current I is flowing across this resistor, then the potential difference across these two is measured using a device and that error in potential difference is given as 3%, which is also equal to difference in percentage error in current. Okay, now this is given to you. Now R is given by V by I. So if I wish to find out relative error in resistance, delta R by R, that will be given by delta V by V plus delta I by I. That is, relative error in resistance will be equal to the sum of relative errors in voltage and current. Now in terms of percentage, delta R by R into 100 will be percentage error in this, which is 3. And percentage error in this, which is also 3. So 6% is the percentage error in the calculation of resistance R. Now let us look at one more simple problem. A boy can throw a stone up to a maximum height of 10 meters. The maximum horizontal distance that the boy can throw the same stone up to will be. Okay? Now, if the boy projects the stone in exactly vertical direction, that means it makes an angle theta equal to 90 degree with the horizontal, then the height attained would be the maximum. Okay? So let us say that velocity is V. V is the limit or the maximum velocity with which a boy can project or throw a stone, right? Now we know that if this is the case, then this maximum height attained by the stone when the stone is projected vertically upward is given by V square upon 2G is equal to height H. Okay, this is one thing. Now second is, in case of maximum range, that means if you project a projectile with an angle of 45 degree, the range is maximum. Now this is the maximum distance that the boy can throw in the horizontal direction. Okay, and the value of maximum range is given by v square by g, which is twice of v square by 2g or twice of 10, that is 20 meters. So this problem was very, very simple. Option D is the correct one.